OpenAI has finally launched the ChatGPT images, which is their image generation as well as edit model, and it is officially called as GPT 1.5. And here are the key changes that they have done compared to the previous model. One is strong instruction following, precise editing, detail preservation, and 4 times faster than before. And here I am in their official blog, and let's see what are the updates that they have done to this new image model. So the good thing is it generates images 4 times faster, and it's really useful for photo edits, clothing, hairstyle try-ons, clothes try-ons, filters, and conceptual transformations. So let's begin with the example. First one is basic editing, like adding, subtracting, combining, blending. Okay, so we are having an image or a couple of images. We want to like combine these images, add a particular thing, remove an object. It does everything streamlined. So here they are having a few examples, 2 people image and a dog, and they have given a prompt to look like in a 2000s film camera, and just look at it, how accurately it has generated. So I would say this is an example of combining. And next we have an example of adding. They have said add kids in the background, and we can see kids coming in the background. And this is the important thing that I can see live in front of my eyes that they have fixed. So this image, this is the original image, right? And the original background, these haven't been altered at all. So if it was the older edit model, like we could have seen a bit of theme change, skin tone change, even background objects getting changed. But now this looks super perfect. Even the background looks intact, the balloons, everything is just retained, and I really like how the things are like overlapping on that. So that's how good it has generated the model. Everything on the table also looks so perfect, even the number of candles. Retaining everything and just changing couple of objects to different style. For example, here we have a normal like realistic photo, right? What they have done is they have changed the face of a man into anime style. So, and they have changed the dog, which was realistic, into this cartoonish style. So very few models were able to actually execute the prompt. The main challenge is you have to retain everything. Everything in the image has to be retained except the face, this person, and the dog. So this is like a really, really challenging prompt, and the new model just has done it easily. And next one is cloth try-on. We are having this t-shirt, and they have just added it to the people. Perfect, literally does everything without damaging the original image. So we are having another example also here, changing the color, and it doesn't disturb the original image. I guess that's the main thing. And they have added this air balloon, eagle, and they have converted this image into a t-shirt. That looks so good. And they have made that same t-shirt to be worn by the same guy. So really good example. And just a short note, if you haven't seen the video of OpenAI for this particular model's release, I highly recommend you to see that. It looked stunning, one of the best AI release videos I've ever seen. And next is going to be creative transformations. Earlier we saw primarily adding, subtracting, and removing things from an image, right? Now we will be completely transforming an image into a particular style. So quite similar to that anime and the cartoon style that we saw. So here we are having a couple of people, and this has converted it into a Hollywood movie poster. So that looks stunning. And we have quite a few examples. We have Altman and 80s instructor. That looks good. Okay. And next we are having few more examples. Yep. As you can see, right, it has completely transformed that image, but we can still say that this person is this image. Okay. We still have similarities. That's a good thing. Okay. About this model. So we're having ornament. Damn, that looks like a oil painting. So they have really like done a pretty amazing job. So this is the cloth ad or something, like, yeah, we are having the cloth as well as the CEO Sam Altman, and it has done a great job, to be honest, over here. So I can really see like the model getting super, super better, like on par with Nano Banana, as far as I've seen the example. So we are having the oil painting over here. Okay, I don't know how Sam agreed to put these things out, but so it's a drink ad. We are having the soda cola. Okay, that's good. And next thing is instruction following. So what this means is whenever you are going to like input images, you will be giving a long description of what the model should perform. So in some cases, the model may skip or do something wrong of the instruction that you have given. So it's also a really important parameter that the model has to do. So here we are having few examples, and I really like how challenging they have given this instruction. And the great thing is they have given the new model as well as the previous model's examples. The prompt is going to remain the same. Here you can see it's saying draw a 6x6 grid. So we will be having, I guess, 36 images. Yeah, we are having 36 images over here, and it's assigning row 1, row 2. So each row will have 6 images. So we are having here Greek letter beta, a beach ball, lemon, robot, a fish tank, etc. So this isn't a single image. This is a single image consisting of 36 individual images in row and column. So this is the best example, I guess, they can go for instruction following, because the first thing is the model needs to understand the row and column pattern. After that, it has to figure out row 1, this particular thing. So it has to like get this letter beta in row 1, first one, and then it needs to get the beach ball over here. So the model has to follow each and every word in that particular prompt, follow the instructions given extremely clearly, then only it can execute it with perfection. And damn, it has done it. Last is number 14, perfect. This is a new model, and here we are having the old model for the exact same prompt. So completely like misaligned, we are not having that 6x6. It's like 4x, I guess, something. But it has also done a pretty good job. I wouldn't complain the old model, but the accuracy is live in front of our eyes over here. And another important feature of image editing or generation models is getting the text over the image. So for me, in my opinion, even the old model was doing a pretty good job, but obviously this new model is going to outperform everything. And damn, that just looks splendid. We are having lot of small text, okay, and it has generated spotlessly. I can't even see a single misalignment of the text. So usually these models will be able to easily generate the larger font images like we are having the introducing GPT 5.2, right? These particular texts will be easily generated because they are larger in size. It gets quite challenging when the size of that text decreases, as well as we are having multiple bold as well as a normal font. It's going to be quite a few challenges, but here it has done an amazing job. Great thing is it has beautifully highlighted the important places. So I guess they would have given it in the prompt, and it has highlighted the keywords over here. So it has beautifully followed the instruction following, which we saw earlier, along with text generation. So that's stunning, and we are having like a couple of examples for that. And not only normal text, it can do this poster images also. And we're also having this coding. So in case if you want to like do a coding presentation, a slideshow, just prompt it over here and attach it. Simple. And next we are having additional quality improvements. So the main thing that they have mentioned is like rendering many small faces and how natural output looks. So this was also a concern that I had earlier, like the faces were slightly misaligned. Like here you can see, right, there's like a bad face over there in the old model. This is the new model, and the difference is like almost day and night how good the quality of the image is. And this looks literally looks like an AI image. The moment we see this, we can say it, but this image we cannot say. It literally looks like an image taken out of the London city. So that's really a crazy improvement that we are seeing over here. And this is just the 1.5 model. So they will be surely launching the 2 model. And this is the place where we can access this images, a new creation space, a new nav bar that we are having. So this is the mobile app, and same is going to apply for the web app also. We are having the images separately. We can click that, and it gives an interface like this where there is like preset of styles. So we are having festive, sketch, many other stuff. And we're also having our previous generation, and rest is self-explanatory. Just upload your image or give a prompt and generate it. Next, they have given about the improvements as well as the limitations. I really appreciate OpenAI for giving the limitations over here. That's really a good thing that they have done. Not many companies do that. This is the same prompt, new model and old model, and just look at the difference. It's like image generated in 1950s and this is like 2100. That's like the difference, how detailed and professional this image is looking. So this is like a poster creation, and here also, just look at this and look at this. It's decades apart, and here is the limitation that they have done. I guess both are fine, but they have given it as an limitation. So let me go to the next one. Multiple faces limitation. Can you make them wear t-shirts saying OpenAI? So the limitation here is, when there are many people, the model has difficulty maintaining the exact identity of every person during editing task. I mean, that's reasonable. We are having like images of so many people, and the model has to like change their clothing. The face can change a bit, so that's not like a big deal, but they have clearly mentioned it over here. And we're having multilingual, which is the languages. So limitations in some languages such as Chinese, Arabic and Hebrew when it comes to text. Okay, so those aren't like a big deal in my opinion. And apart from that, we are having GPT image 1.5 in the API. If you're having credits in OpenAI API, you can just try it out. It's directly available in the OpenAI playground. And we're also having the prompt guide over here to give better prompting. You can just like go through it in case if you want to like do it with the API, and in general also this will be like really helpful for you. This is the pricing over here, GPT image 1.5. It's about $8 input and output is 32, and that's cheaper than GPT image 1. So not a great reduction in the price, but still makes sense. I mean, it's a better model anyways. Let's get on to the availability. The new ChatGPT images is rolling out to all users. So even if you are like a free user of ChatGPT, you can use that. So here I am in my ChatGPT and I'm having the images tab. So you can just click it and try it out. So we are having the images, you can upload your image and give instructions through text or dictate through voice. And we are having some pretext available, and yep, same thing also. And here I'm having the previously created images. So it's live now. Just try it out, and that's the video guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. There are a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.